Hello everyone. Today we'll be doing the chapter Journey by Night. So many of you might have gone to safaris in jungles. You might have seen elephants or tigers and lions and rhinos, maybe even cobras slithering around here and there. So you might have thought of that as a very interesting experience. But what if it becomes a necessity to travel in the jungle at night between all these animals around you and no safety? Such an expedition was led by our hero, the protagonist of the story. So let us first have a quick look at the summary of the story. Sher Singh was the son of Sher Singh Bahadur the Brave and the famous shikari who had got the title Bahadur for his hunting skills. One day, when his father was away in the jungle on a photographic expedition with some strangers, Sher Singh's younger brother, Kovar, fell seriously ill. His mother gave some home remedy to Kovar without success. So she felt that Kovar had to be carried to the hospital in Kalaghat. As his father and the elders in the village were away, and as his mother ought to look after the cattle and the farming, Sher Singh decided to stay to carry Kovar to the hospital. Sher Singh's mother made him a sling from her sari for Sher Singh to carry Kovar. In the evening, Sher Singh began the journey to Kalaghat, carrying his brother in the sling. Kalaghat was at best 50 miles away, but Sher Singh thought that if he took the shortcut through the jungle and crossed the two rivers, he might get a lift in a passing vehicle. As he was moving through the jungle, his jungle sense helped him to escape from stepping on a cobra and sure death. So till now we see that Sher Singh's younger brother Kovar has fallen seriously ill and no home remedy is working on him and he is getting ill time by time. So now what happens is that his father, who is really strong and brave and courageous, who can take him to Kalaghat, which is very far, 50 miles is a lot of distance. So his father could take him there, but he is out on an expedition. So Sher Singh, the son of Sher Singh Bahadur, he decides that he was going to save his brother, and his mother, for his convenience, makes him a sling out of her sari, and then he carries Kovar in that sling through the jungle. Now let's read ahead. As he walked through the forest, he was terrified. He felt that the weight of his brother was too much for him. When he came to the riverbed, he decided to take rest for a while. When he placed Kovar on the ground, he saw a herd of elephants jostling through the forest. Sher Singh was frightened and helpless. He could neither climb nor run carrying his brother. Fortunately, the herd left the brothers alone and went away. He lifted Kovar with great effort and trod into the shallow river. As he splashed onto the shore, he saw newly made footprints of a tiger. However, he proceeded courageously and reached the second river by midnight. The snow had melted, the river was full with a strong current, and the Kacha bridge was submerged. Weaving some grass into a rope, Sher Singh tied it around his brother and himself to keep them together. And then he entered the river and moved forward with great difficulty. He was careful to keep Kovar's head above water. Sher Singh found it an enormous struggle to carry the weight of his brother and move through the cold and strong current in the river. So now we see that he encounters various animals along the way. First, he protects himself by not stepping onto a cobra. Next, a jostling herd of elephants passes through them. Just by some luck, they leave the brothers alone. Then he sees the footprints of a tiger, which may be roaming around. But he escapes all these dangers and he moves forward. But as he moves forward, he encounters a river. Because of the melting of ice, the river is overflowing and brimming with water. Now what he does, he uses his quick wit, his presence of mind, and he connects his and his brother's body using a rope. Eventually, after a determined struggle, he was able to cross the river and reach the road to Kalaghat. Then he was able to get a lift in a bullock cart and a truck and reach Kalaghat hospital to admit his ailing brother. After admitting his brother to the hospital, Sher Singh got some work in the rail yards and earned some money to get a few things to cook a meal. At the hospital, the doctor was amazed that Sher Singh was the boy who brought the sickly Kumar from Ledwani. Ledwani was the place from where they originally belonged. The doctor called him Sher Singh Bahadur and assured him that his brother would live. So now we see by the end of the story, even the doctor is very surprised how good Sher Singh was able to bring Kumar to Kalaghat, which was like 50 miles away. Because even at the starting of the story, when we read the story, we find that when Sher Singh decides to take Kumar to Kalaghat, even his mother says that he is too big for you. Even she is very skeptical about it and she does not think that he would be able to make it. Yet his determination, his love for his brother and his willingness to cross the jungle and make it to Kalaghat helps him get there. And we also see that again he is not at all dependent on anybody, on any money of his family or anybody else. Rather, he takes up a work in the rail yard and from the money he gets, he cooks his own meals and stays put. Now let us go through the themes of the chapter. The first is the power of human will. So we see that, as I already talked, even Sher Singh's mother was very skeptical that he would not be able to carry Kumar. Even the doctor, he was very surprised and shocked that Sher Singh was able to bring Kumar to the hospital. But it was the power of his will. It was his dedication, his determination that he was able to bring Kumar to Kalaghat. Next is fraternal love. Fraternal love is the love for one brother, to one brother from another. So it's basically brotherly love, and the love between Sher Singh and Kumar helped in the power of human will. Next is the theme of struggle. See, the family that has been shown, it is a family which struggles to make ends meet because they're into farming, and the father goes out on occasional expeditions on hunting. And in such a scenario, if something happens, like influenza happened to Kumar, in that scenario, nobody is there to take care of them. And neither is any hospital nearby. So such is a life of struggle in which you have to make ends meet somehow. Next is hope, the theme of hope. Even when his mother had decided that Kumar might not live, even then, Sher Singh had the hope that he would help him live. He would take him to the hospital and he would be optimistic about it and he will live. Now we will consider the character sketch of Sher Singh. Firstly, we can say that he was courageous. Obviously, at night he took his brother in the jungles between among all these animals, so he was very courageous and brave. Next, he was very determined, because such a journey is not possible without the power of will and determination. He had a sense of duty. He knew that being the eldest son, when his father was away, he had a duty towards his family. And this responsibility of his, he kept it foremost. Next, he was optimistic and hopeful. Even when, as I already told you, even when the mother had thought that Kumar might not live, even then he was hopeful that he would make it to the hospital and Kumar would live. Next, he was loving. Obviously, brotherly love, as we can see in the chapter. Next, he had the never give up attitude. He never gave up. Even when the elephants came, he stayed put. He used his presence of mind and he saved himself and his brother. Also, another time when he did not step on the cobra, he had the never give up attitude. Even when he saw the footprints of the tiger, he made sure that he remained calm. Even in the overflowing river, he remained calm and showed his presence of mind, and that was his never give up attitude. Now we'll be looking at a RTC from the chapter. Let us first read the extract and then we'll be moving on to the questions. But this beautiful creature of metallic scales with poison in its teeth wanted only to get away, as the boy himself did. It subsided and slid off into the matted grass. Sher Singh drew a breath. The snake feeling left his legs and he was able to walk on. So this is the extract that we've got from the chapter. Now let's read the first question. What is this beautiful creature of metallic scales? What was the creature doing on the jungle path? What did it do when Sher Singh stepped close to it? So, we have to answer this question according to the extract. In the extract, in the very first line, we have the beautiful creature of metallic scales mentioned. Now, please understand, in an RTC, you have to answer according to the extract, but you also have to use your previous knowledge of the chapter. So, this metallic scales creature, we already know it was a cobra. So, let us read the answer and try to understand it elaborately. This beautiful creature of metallic scales is the cobra snake, as we discussed. The creature was sunning itself on the jungle path. As soon as Sher Singh stopped close to it, it swayed, watching him, its tongue playing in and out like a leech. This creature only wanted to get away, as the boy himself did. He therefore subsided and slid into the matted grass without harming anyone, and harming anyone, including the boy. So we see that this answer has been directly taken from the extract. Next question. What was Sher Singh's reaction when his eyes fell on the creature? What did he do next? So we see that although this is also related to the extract, but you will also have to use your own knowledge in this context. So when he saw the snake, obviously at once he was a little scared on stepping to it, because when a cobra snake bites you, you might die. So he was very apprehensive about it and he was a little scared. But soon he figured out that even the snake, he was just sunning himself, and even he just wanted to go on his own path, just like Sher Singh did. Let's read the answer. As soon as Sher Singh's eyes fell on the creature, he stood frozen. He then very slowly backed away and the snake slid off into the matted grass. Sher Singh drew a breath, the snake feeling left his legs and he was able to walk on. Next question. Where was Sher Singh heading towards? What plan had he had in mind to reach the place? So again, this is, see the extract we have been given, it's an extract of the journey, right? But what was the purpose of the journey is actually being asked in this question. So this is a question that is somehow related to the extract, but you will have to use your previous knowledge of the chapter. So where was Sher Singh headed? We know that he was headed to the Kalaghat hospital. And what was his plan? His plan was to go to the shortcut through the jungle, cross over the two rivers, and then finally get a lift from a bullock cart or some passing vehicle to the hospital. Let's read the answer. Sher Singh was heading towards the hospital at Kalaghat. Sher Singh hoped that if he could get through the jungle and cross the two rivers that lay between him and his goal, he might get a lift in a bullock cart or perhaps even a broken down truck for the last part of his journey. So we see that you have to answer to the point, but according to the marks you can elaborate it, and if the marks are more, give a little bit of background and tell a little bit of what happened later. So let us look at the last question. What were the challenges in the jungle presented to the boy? Why did the beasts of prey pose more danger to humans now than before? So the first part of the question, you'll basically have to summarize the journey Sher Singh underwent in the jungle. And the second part, you can take a bit of the context from the chapter. The rest of it, you can use your own presence of mind and write. So let's read the answer. The primeval jungle in which the struggle of vegetation and of life continued presented a number of challenges to the boy. Luxuriant bamboo sprang fast from its nodules. Impenetrable thorn thickets fought for air, and undergrowth and scrubs and grass. This made it difficult for the boy to pass through. Also, there were a number of animals that lived in the jungle: monkeys, raucous peacocks, tiger, panther, bear, and elephant. The beasts of prey posed more threat to humans and to domestic animals now than before, because the deer were now so poached and decimated. So in the first part, you can further elaborate it by putting in the incidents that Sher Singh faces with the animals such as tiger, cobra, and the elephants. Okay. And the second part, again, we know that human poaching and human hunting has already led to the endangerment and extinction of many animals, and many more are keep coming in the picture of endangerment. So you can further elaborate that here.